Hello, massage nerds. Today we're going to be doing the respiratory pathologies. Quick review on asthma, bronchitis, common cold, emphysema, hay fever, influenza, pneumonia, and sinusitis. So I'm going to do all eight of them today. This chapter is not as large and doesn't have as many pathologies. And the reason I break up the others is because I do my best to type in the description a little review for those of you that are readers and need to read it. Go to the description. However, I'm only allowed 5,000 characters, so that's why I break them apart, you know, break them in two, part one and part two, when there's too many pathologies. So we'll start with asthma. Asthma is bronchospasms, and it causes them difficulty in breathing. It's usually caused by allergic reactions and other hypersensitivities. It is also common, very common in children. And what it does is that it's inflammation of the respiratory mucosa. And so it's difficult for them to breathe. They usually carry inhalers with them. And make sure that you ask your client what are some of the triggers. Like candles might be one of the triggers, or scents. So always ask them, make sure you like what triggers them. And I know that one of the things that I like to use that I brought for a show and tell is the wedge. I have found this big wedge, and they lay, you know, you're able to put it on the table so they can lay supine, so they're a little bit, you know, higher up on an incline. And this isn't the one I use at the office, but this is just for me here. But however, this incline on the supine position is very helpful for people that have asthma, emphysema, COPD, that's harder for them to breathe. You always want to prop them up a little bit so that it's easier for them to breathe. So you might want to try that. I just wanted to show you guys. So make sure that you find out, like I said, if they have asthma. You know, it's common with children, but also in adults, and they carry an inhaler. So the next one would be bronchitis. And remember, anytime you see the suffix itis, means inflammations. And, you know, broncho has to do with a bronchitis, with a bronchial. So it's inflammation of the bronchial tubes that go into the lungs. Acute bronchitis is usually an upper respiratory infection, and it's massage is contraindicated until they've gone without a fever more than 24 hours. Now, chronic bronchitis is usually exacerbated with, you know, airborne pollutants. If people leave that live near factories, or cigarette smoke and secondhand smoke, you know, some people have chronic bronchitis. So what it does is the cilia are the little hairs in your lungs, you know, that kind of help move the mucus, you know, move. They don't function properly. They're damaged. So their bronchioles are really damaged. And another thing that you can do is use the wedge. You know, don't lay them completely flat, but maybe at a little bit of an incline. And if they had a fever, you want to make sure that you wait 24 hours before you give them a massage. So the third one is the common cold, which is the most contagious. Like in high schools, that's the most contagious, you know, it's an upper respiratory infection. And because it is contagious, you definitely don't want to work on a client. You want to wait until they are completely well. And so massage is contraindicated with anybody with a cold. The next one would be emphysema. And emphysema is a permanent enlargement of the lower airways. And their alveolar are in the lungs are destroyed, so they already have scar tissue and the alveoli, so the walls are destroyed and they have really difficulty breathing. And this is a type of pathology that you see with smokers, you know, with smokers and people that work in environments that are very toxic, you know, in a factory or near factories. So this is something that, you know, they already are taking medication, they're on inhalers. So again, put them on an incline, you know, if they're going to lay supine. A lot of times what helps with people with emphysema and asthma and any of the pulmonary pathologies, is to put him prone and do a little bit of cupping, you know, when allowed, when they're not sick and they don't have a fever, obviously. Some of the cupping is really, really good because it really helps open up those airways and breathe better. So you want to be careful with somebody that has emphysema, depending on the stage. And, you know, like I said, always make your client comfortable. So the next one is hay fever, and this is hypersensitivity of the nasal mucosa. And they usually have allergies to pollens and, like I said, scents. So hay fever is not as, I don't want to get in trouble for saying it's not as dangerous. Because I know that, you know, somebody will say, oh, you know, I have hay fever and I feel like I'm dying. So, however, it is being just hypersensitivity when other people are not. And this is to the nasal mucosa. So hay fever is still up in your head more than into your lungs. You know, once it's, you know, emphysema or asthma, that's already in your lungs. So again, just talk to your client and find out, you know, what's more comfortable for them and how to position them better. I know that a prone position works better for clients, and also sidelines. So consider that too. So the next one is the famous influenza, the flu. This is highly contagious, and it's a virus, and it's, and, you know, usually upper respiratory. However, it can go to the upper respiratory, is from the trachea up, you know, and then lower is already when it starts getting into the bronchioles and into your lungs. So it can get into your lungs. You know, it's contraindicated to give a massage to somebody that has the flu, influenza, and until the client is well. And the book says that there are approximately 38,000 people die a year. However, I looked it up on the CDC and it says up to 60,000 people die a year from the flu. And now we're dealing with COVID, and COVID has already killed over 400,000. So there's a difference, 60,000 to 400,000. So, you know, it is highly contagious, so you want to take precautions. You know, it's contraindicated to work anybody that has the flu. And again, you want to make sure that they are well, that they're not contagious anymore, and that, you know, that they can breathe good. So the next one is pneumonia. Pneumonia is an infection and inflammation of the lungs, and it's usually preceded by the flu or COVID. Or the common cold. The pneumonia kills about 55,000 people a year. It is triggered either by bacteria or a virus, and is the number one cause in deaths in children, is pneumonia. So massage is contraindicated until they are fully recovered. And it's usually, like I said, it's usually, you know, from bronchitis, it comes first, and, you know, a cold, and then it turns into bronchitis, it's already going into your lungs, and then it could turn into pneumonia. That's why, you know, it is dangerous. This is dangerous. So make sure that your clients have been okayed from the doctor, that they're fully recovered before you work on anybody that has pneumonia. And last but not least is sinusitis. Again, itis is there. Itis of anything means it's inflamed. And sinusitis is inflammation of the sinuses, chronic inflammation, or acute of the mucosa lining of the paranasal. You know, para, that prefix, paraspinals, parathyroids means it works next to, para means next to. So paranasal sinuses are right next to, and they work in conjunction. So these are become chronic after 12 weeks. You know, people that have recurrent episodes of infections, you know, or inflammation in the sinus, you know, they usually have allergies to molds, to airborne, you know, fungus, or have been exposed to chemicals. So you want to make sure that you postpone, especially if they have a fever, you want to postpone any massage until if they have a fever. And, you know, you can do some trigger points after. However, I will warn you, people that have had sinusitis, trigger points around, you know, the nasal. You know, you've got your ethmoid and sphenoid bones that you want to make sure and work all this area. However, very gentle, because it is hypersensitive. It hurts. You might want to apply maybe like a little, like a wash, a cold wash rag, you know, or warm, depending on what feels better for the client. They do recommend, you know, a little bit of heat to help them drain. And I can guarantee you that people that have sinusitis, it's really difficult for them to go face down, to go prone. So you might want to turn them sideline, you know, if they're still sensitive and they're still have pain, you want to consider a sideline position. I actually do sideline position almost every time, you know, with my clients, especially when they have pathologies. Don't forget, supine, prone and sideline, and some work better. Like people with lungs and respiratory problems, you know, prone is usually better and more beneficial than supine, and some of them are sideline work better. So always talk to your client. You know, like I said, all of these are the respiratory pathologies, and some of them can be severe. Acute, remember, is less than 3 weeks. Chronic is when it's been going on longer than 3 weeks and it keeps recurring. So that's when it becomes chronic. So anyway, we're almost done with pathology. I'll be glad when we're done with pathology, guys. It's like I'm beginning to think like I have all of these, you know. It's like, oh my God, you start getting all panicky thinking of all the pathologies. Oh my God, I don't want to make a mistake with my clients. And, you know, so it's difficult to work only with pathology. So just take a deep breath. Do your research before your client comes in. If you can get information over the phone, you'll be fine. You guys will handle it fine. It doesn't, you know, it's not common that you get, you know, somebody with a lot of pathologies every time. So anyway, but I think we only have like five more pathologies to do. I know we have the digestive, the urinary, and the integumentary system. So anyway, we'll just keep going until we're done. And until the next time, create a great day.